Someone here is in pain. I see you. You've suffered a long time, haven't you? Is it drugs? And you've tried so many times to stop, but it has its grip on you. Sometimes you think the only answer is to end it all. You even thought about ending it tonight before you came here.
How could you know?
Stand up with me, dear. Stand up. I spent a real long time in the gutter with my own addictions. And if God can heal me, He can heal anyone. In Jesus' name, you are healed from this addiction.
And he was shocked when he got there.
Did you know Miles Morales?
This is one thing that makes Jesus angry. One day Jesus went to a temple and he was shocked when he got there. People had turned the temple into a marketplace. They were selling all kinds of things and business was booming. Jesus got very angry, overturned the tables and chased everyone out. He told them that a temple is a house of prayer and not a house of business. Type "I agree with Jesus" in the comments and subscribe for more. This is one
reason that heaven is better than earth is not just because I'm upgrading my dwelling place, not just because my questions will be answered, but I'll be with Christ. Paul says, I want to desire and be with Christ, which is far better. So what is heaven like? Short answer, amazing. Better than anything you ever imagined. It's beyond your wildest dreams.
Let's pray today. Lord God, I lift up the person who is with me right now. I pray that your presence is strong and comforting in this individual's life today, Lord, as they walk and do the things that they feel called to do with their life. I pray that they honor you, Lord. They trust you. They continue to demonstrate their faith in everything that they're putting their hands to work on, Lord. And I just pray that you guide them, you protect them, you bless them, you use them to do great things with their life today and to finish this week strong. In Jesus' name I claim amen. If you pray
to you that Jesus is coming back soon. Jesus said in the book of Matthew that in the last days, right before he comes back, that there would be wars and rumors of wars. He also said that there would be racial tensions on the earth. And lastly, Jesus said there would be pandemics and pestilences on the earth. If you believe that Jesus is coming back soon, hit that subscribe button now.
Whenever you feel like God can't forgive your sins, remember this. God forgave Paul, a man who killed Christians and turned him into a teacher of the gospel. God takes your pain and suffering and uses it for good towards his kingdom. God is using this season of your life for ways beyond what we can understand. And you just have to trust him. Isaiah 60:22 says, "At the right time, I, the Lord, will make it happen." God knows your troubles, and when the time is right, he will heal you.
Have you looked outside recently or turned on the news or scrolled through social media and thought, what the heck is happening in the world right now? There is so much confusion. I want you to take comfort in this. It was actually prophesied in the Bible that this would happen. The prophet Isaiah said that there's coming a time when people will call evil good and good evil. And I'm telling you, if you were to look outside right now, it's really interesting how those who are actually righteous are being persecuted and are being shut up, but those who are wicked and lawless are being given a platform. Here's what I want you to consider. The Bible says that God is not the author of confusion, but the father of lies. Satan is the prince of the air, and he's the one manipulating the culture right now. But you don't need to take the bait. How will you protect yourself in these days? By nosediving into the Word of God, reading it every single day, and allowing the Word to renew your mind and to transform your life. We need it now more than ever. If you agree, click follow or subscribe.